you make of the health insurance space in a world where some candidates who favor single payer actually have a real shot at the Democratic presidential nomination? We just heard from Cramer fave Centene this morning. Here's a managed care provider that focuses on government-sponsored plans. They just completed their acquisition of WellCare, making them one of the largest players in the industry, actually one of the largest companies in the country. Centene reported a mostly solid quarter with inline earnings, higher than expected sales. There were some blemishes, like a weaker than anticipated medical loss ratio. We'll cover that, meaning they had to spend more on coverage. But Centene's shares ultimately got hit today, closing down 1.4%. Although you got to remember that stock's up nearly 50% over the past 4 months, and the whole time we've been following in on it. So the question is, can the stock resume its run? Let's check in with Michael Neidorff. He's the chairman and CEO of Centene. He had a better rate in the quarter and the WellCare deal. Mr. Neidorff, welcome back to Mad Money.
Thank you.
Okay, so Michael, first thing I got to ask you, do you like wake up in the middle of the night and say, you know what, there are candidates in the Democratic Party who would basically make it so that there is no Centene?
No. You know, if you look at the whole thing, Jim, you know Medicare for all, that's a soundbite.
Right.
You know, you look at what it would cost. We can't afford it. $38 billion on a $58 billion, but trillion, I'm sorry.
Trillion.
Trillion over 10 years, not affordable. Also, the only way a single payer controls costs is to withhold service.
Right.
And I can show you in many places where that's the case. Americans aren't going to put up with that.
Now, in an exchange, how much service is withheld?
None.
None.
It works. I mean, our exchange is so successful. We had 82% renew. We had a 86% effectuation rate. It's just every ask, 96% effectuation, excuse me. It's a very successful product. People like it.
Now, people do like it, but I only hear about it from you. And I wonder whether that isn't because no one seems to know this is going to change. Michael, people still don't know who Centene is. You're gigantic. Maybe you got to change your name or something.
Well, you know, that's the way it happens to me. I can't figure it out either. I've talked to people about it.
But you are the biggest.
We're a $100-plus billion company this year. We'll be in the 20s when they look at it this year.
Fortune 20 company.
We're in the 120 or so in that internationally. You know? But, you know, I'm not worried about that. Right. What I'm worried about is our shareholders. I was just looking. Over the last 10 years, there's been a 28% CAGR.
Right.
On shareholder price. Right. So, you know, you look at those things, that's really what counts.
Well, okay, so a lot of that is bought, but you had really good organic growth this quarter.
Yes, it's been good all year. This past year, we had close to $7 billion in organic growth. And we're focused on organic growth. Now, the WellCare deal, that was very special.
Right. But are you going to keep buying, or are you done?
Well, I said today on the call, we will buy capability.
Right.
Okay, and that's important. But at the right time, the right place, if we see the right opportunity, sure, we'll buy it.
Now, one of the things that you said on your call that, you know, people just, they want to go right to that medical loss ratio. You call it another thing, benefits ratio. Mm-hmm. But you did something, you know, just glossed over because that's the way our business is done. But it's got to stop. You did Social Health Bridge, OPN Youth Challenge, Food for Today, Food for Tomorrow. These are what I care about.
It's holistic.
Let's hear about it.
Well, what we've done is we've identified opportunities to help people in a very holistic way. And we've been doing this for years, long before they had the terminology for us.
Right.
And we find that, you know, it takes treating the whole person. If you're worried about your food, you know, your health state's not going to be good. So by doing this, we find we improve the health state.
All right. Now, the president I'm not sure where he actually stands other than the fact that I know that he thinks the exchanges are a failure, okay? How does he think the exchanges are a failure, or is that just rhetoric?
I think
because we have the State of the Union address.
I think there's some rhetoric. I mean, if you look at the success of the program and where things are at, it's just like, you know, you were talking about this quarter and our MLR.
We're going to get to that.
Okay.
Well, talk about it, because, look, you talk about it's a moderate increase in flu-related. We're going to get to that in a second. Yeah. But you said they were higher than your costs were higher than our expectations. I'm not used to seeing that on a Centene quarter.
What happened is we also explained a lot of it was we had some balanced billing issues.
So billing issues.
Yes. Well, you know, somebody goes to a non-participating provider.
Right.
So we settled all that with those providers. That's a one-time. But part of that settlement was they became providers.
I
so
see.
We took the one-time hit, for that right. payment in a quarter, but it's going to benefit us this year and going forward.
All right, well, that's important.
So, you know, you do these
okay, so it comes out in the wash.
Yeah, it makes sense.
All right, so we have, maybe you can give us this perspective. We've had a horrendous flu season, haven't we?
It's been stronger than it typically is.
Do you think it's cavalier to say we should be thinking about the almost the 9,000 deaths that we've had from the flu before we just completely drive ourselves nuts about the coronavirus?
Well, I've talked about that. That's the average year. But, you know, the coronavirus, it's captured everybody's attention.
Right.
And I think we need to take steps to protect against it. I was glad to see the FDA now has a test for people so they know whether they really have it or
right.
not. So, I mean, we need to do what we can to protect people. But, you know, every year there is a flu. It's a fact of life. And unfortunately, 8,000 people in this 9,000 in this country die of flu every year.
How about if they got the shot? Do you think it would be a lot lower?
I think it helps. You know, we do everything we can to encourage it. We provide the free shots. We do a fluentrin program with TV ads and things. We call it fluentrin.
Fluentrin. You like those things, though.
Yeah. Yeah, it's one of these things where we tell people to help prevent the flu, right. get your injections.
But you don't sound scared about this coronavirus.
Well, I'm concerned, but, you know, at every generation, we always have something, and we deal with it. As you deal with the facts as you have it today, and we're continuing to do that, and that's all you can do. And if I want to ensure that if somebody has the flu or has an issue, they get the highest quality of care. Because that long-term is what really counts.
Okay. That's Michael Neidorff, Chairman and CEO of Centene. Guys, this is a gigantic company. It's big in the area that a lot of people think isn't doing well, but it is good. And you heard from Michael. People like the service. Mad Money's back after the break.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com. Or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.